नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज 50th लेक्चर ऑफ अबाउट ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियरिंग। आई एम थैंकफुल टू ऑल माय व्यूअर्स। आई आल्सो एक्सटेंड माय थैंक्स टू ऑल दोज हु हैव एनकरेज्ड मी फ्रॉम टाइम टू टाइम। माय थैंक्स आर आल्सो ड्यू टू ऑल दोज हु हैव मेड वैल्यूएबल सजेशंस दैट हैज इम्प्रूव्ड माय वर्क। इन दिस लेक्चर आल्सो I will continue my discussion on brakes. In previous lecture, I had talked about hydraulic brakes. In this lecture, I would be talking about air brakes or compressed air brake system. We have already learned that when brake pedal is pressed, force applied is transferred to brake shoes in wheels. These move and friction between brake shoes and wheel drum or calipers and disc occurs. This causes actuation of brakes. In automobiles or other vehicles, actuation of brake occurs in all four wheels simultaneously. We have seen that in hydraulic brakes, fluid in liquid form is the medium to transmit force from brake pedal two wheels. This system is suitable for light vehicles. In 1872, an American engineer, George Westinghouse, patented air brakes to be used in railways. He improved these further that led to different forms of automatic brakes in railways. These were later adopted in heavy vehicles. In air brakes, working medium is air. Air is used in compressed form, therefore they are also known as compressed air brake systems. For air brakes, air should be at about 750 kilopascal. This is essential for proper operation of brakes. If pressure drops, brakes may not be actuated properly. This is a matter of concern as it may cause accident. A gauge is provided in front of driver so that he knows if there is drop in pressure. Additionally, an alarm is provided to alert driver. Parking brakes are engaged through springs. When applied, springs exert pressure and resistance is created. This does not allow vehicle to move when parked. Air pressure here is used to disengage parking brake. Air brake system consists of 1. Supply system and 2. Control system. Supply system. It has air compressor as main component. It is driven by vehicle engine. It may be directly connected to engine through gears. Alternatively, pulley and belt arrangement can be used to connect them. To lubricate and cool compressor, lubrication and cooling system of engine are used. Compressed air also requires cooling. It is made to pass through a cooling coil. In this cooling coil, its temperature is reduced. Next, it passes through dryer to remove moisture. Any other impurity that may be present is also removed. Finally, it is stored in main reservoir. From here, it is sent to primary and secondary reservoirs. Primary reservoir supplies compressed air to rear brakes. Similarly, secondary reservoir provides compressed air to front brakes. Compressed air is also supplied to parking brake and auxiliary reservoir. The system is provided with safety valve. Safety valve keeps pressure within permissible limit. Supply system also provides warning to driver in case of pressure drop. control system. It has different brake circuits. There is main brake circuit actuating brakes. It splits into two systems, one for rear brakes and one for front brakes. This is done for the safety of vehicle. If by any chance one system fails, actuation of brake in all the four wheels is not affected. When brake pedal is pressed, both circuits are operated simultaneously. This is done through air valve regulating supply to both circuits. There is a separate circuit for parking brake in control system. Main components. The main components of air brake system are 1. Air cleaner, 2. Air compressor, 3. Governor, 4. Dryer, 5. Air reservoir, 6. Brake pedal, and 7. Brake valve. Apart from these components, air brake system has slack adjuster and S-cam. With the help of these two, brake shoes are pushed. These come in frictional contact with wheel drum and brakes are actuated. Use of disc brakes is not common in heavy vehicles. Disc brakes have higher efficiency as compared to drum brakes. However, they cost more. Let us go into the details of different components. Referring to block diagram, air cleaner. Whenever air is used as working medium, it is very essential that it is free from dust particles. Dust particles may be present in atmospheric air. These dust particles, if present between two surfaces in contact, act like emery paper. This causes very quick wearing of surfaces in contact. Air cleaner is in the form of perforated screen. Size of perforations is such that dust particles cannot pass through the screen. This makes air being used in brake system dust free. Other impurities, if present, are also removed as air passes through the screen. Air compressor. Atmospheric air is sucked in and is compressed. Air compressor is driven by vehicle engine. As soon as engine starts, compressor starts functioning. Generally, belt drive connects engine with compressor, though sometimes gear may also be used. Governor. Governor controls the pressure of air at which it is delivered to air reservoir. It is highly essential to keep air pressure within permissible limit. If pressure goes beyond permissible limit, release valve operates to reduce it. Release valve may be operated manually or automatically. Dryer. This removes any moisture that may be present in air being used. Moisture in atmospheric air may be present due to climatic conditions. Presence of moisture is not acceptable as it may corrode metallic components. Dry air is used in air brake system. Generally, heating coil is employed that works with electricity. Heat generated through coil removes moisture. Air reservoir. It is a storage tank. It stores compressed air. As air is at high pressure, it must be able to withstand this pressure. Its capacity is such that it can store ample amount of air. Brakes are to be applied repeatedly. There should be enough compressed air to carry out repeated application of brakes. Its higher capacity also helps in carrying operation even when supply of air is obstructed from compressor temporarily. Brake pedal. When pressed by driver, it causes actuation of brakes. It is a foot pedal and can easily be operated by driver. Brake valve. It is also known as triple valve. Building of pressure in brake lines is required as brakes are applied. Similarly, when actuation of brakes is not required and brake pedal is released, air pressure in brake lines is also released. This is achieved through brake valve. As already explained about the requirement of compressed air, two additional reservoirs are provided. One supplies air to rear brakes and other supplies air to front brakes. Referring back to diagram, there is primary reservoir as can be seen on right hand side to supply compressed air to rear brakes. Similarly, another reservoir known as secondary reservoir shown on left side supplies compressed air to front brakes. The other two components that contribute to actuation of brakes are 1. Slack adjuster and 2. S-cam. Let us go into details of these components. Slack adjuster. It is connected with push rod on one side and S-cam on other side. Referring to diagram, its lower portion is circular in shape. It has provision for mounting in the form of hole with center O. There are teeth on inner edge to facilitate mounting as shown. Upper portion is housing that has straight arm-like shape with hole. This hole is attachment point for yoke of push rod. There is a locking screw on left side. A steel ball in slot does not allow lateral movement of worm shaft. Screw keeps ball in locked position. It has worm and gear arrangement as can be seen. Gear wheel meshes with worm. There is an adjusting screw on left side. Greasing is essential for its proper working. Greasing plug is provided that can be seen on left side. Upon application of brake, push rod moves towards right. Upper end of housing also moves with it, causing adjuster to rotate in clockwise direction about center O. When brake is released, push rod moves towards left with upper end of housing. This causes anti-clockwise rotation of adjuster about center O. S cam. This is cam with S shape. Referring to diagram, it is hinged in the middle. It can move about this hinge. Upon application of brakes, as slack adjuster rotates, S cam also moves about hinge and causes pushing of brake shoes. This causes frictional contact between them and wheel drum. Upon release of brake pedal, S-cam moves back about hinge. Brake shoes come back to original position and frictional contact between them and wheel drum is lost. Working of air brakes. Referring to block diagram, fluid lines are shown in blue. Air enters in air cleaner as shown on left side. From there it goes to compressor and in compressed form it passes through dryer where its moisture is removed. Next it is collected in air reservoir in compressed and dry state. Fluid lines connect air reservoir to brake valve with governor positioned as shown. Governor keeps a check on pressure in fluid lines and air reservoir. When brake pedal is pressed, brake valve releases compressed air. This moves through brake lines shown in red. There are two brake lines. One connects brake valve to primary reservoir. Reservoir is connected to air chambers to actuate brakes in both rear wheels. Other brake line connects brake valve to secondary reservoir. Secondary reservoir is connected to air chambers to actuate brake in both front wheels as shown. Air chambers are provided with diaphragm and return springs to operate push rod. When brake pedal is released, push rod moves backwards as return spring in air chamber retains its original position. Compressed air is pushed back in brake lines. Brake valve allows this compressed air to go back to reservoir. Let us try to understand how brakes are actuated in road wheels. For this, I will take up another diagram. This diagram contains details of air chamber, push rod, slack adjuster and S-cam. This was avoided in previous block diagram for the sake of simplicity. Referring to diagram, one on left represents application of brake and that on right represents release of brake. Looking at diagram on left, compressed air enters the air chamber from left side when brake pedal is pressed. Push rod moves towards right against the force of return spring. This causes pushing of upper end of housing of slack adjuster and it rotates about O as shown. With it, S-cam rotates about hinge at O. This pushes brake shoes on left and right outwards causing actuation of brakes. Looking at diagram on right, brake pedal is released, return spring attains original position and push rod moves back towards left. S-cam attains its new position as shown. Brake shoes move back, contact between brake shoes and wheel drum is lost and there is no resistance to motion. Compressed air moves back to reservoir through brake linings and brake valve. Repeated application of brakes causes wearing of brake lining on shoes. As these wear out, gap between brake shoes and wheel drum goes on increasing. This affects the actuation of brakes. Therefore, adjustment is required to be done periodically to reduce this gap. System explained requires manual adjustment. A modified design of slack adjuster does not require manual adjustment of gap between brake shoes and wheel drum. Gap between brake lining and wheel drum consists of three parts. These are A. Preset constructive gap, B. Gap due to brake lining wear, and C. Gap dependent upon elasticity of wheel drum and brake lining. Out of these, gap due to brake lining wear is required to be adjusted from time to time. Automatic slack adjuster maintains this gap on its own. Here, I conclude the discussion. Thanks for watching.